Tell me if this sounds familiar. You're feeling pretty good about life, happy where you are, and then you start scrolling social media. You see friends and family going on vacations you want to go on, buying things you want to buy, and just generally looking happier than you. This sends you into a tailspin of sadness and frustration about how your life isn't as good as theirs. That is the comparison trap, and today I'm going to be talking about how you can stop comparing yourself to others, so stick around. Hi, I'm Jess of JessDickerson.com, and I'm a life coach helping you go from stress to success by giving you the tools to be more confident, more motivated, and less stressed. If you want to be sure not to miss an episode, go down and hit the subscribe button below. By the end of this video, you're going to have 5 ways that drastically cut back the chances that you're going to get stuck in the comparison trap. We've all been there. One day you're feeling really great about your house, and then the next day you drive through an expensive neighborhood. Or you feel really happy about your car, and then your friend pulls up in a new one. You were all excited about that road trip until you saw pictures of your coworker on white sandy beaches with a tropical beverage in hand. Comparing ourselves to others can go 2 ways. On one way, it can make you less happy about what you have and feel envious and depressed. On the other hand, if you feel like you won the comparison, then it can make you feel better than or smug, which isn't a good look on anyone. And while there's nothing new about the whole keeping up with the Joneses thing, this age of social media means that you have so many more people that you can compare yourselves to at the touch of a screen. The issue with comparison is twofold. Not only does it make you feel less happy, it also robs you of time that you could be using to improve your life. And if you're left feeling depressed after the comparison, you're probably not going to be in the mood to work on your life to get it to be the way you want it to be. So let's dive in. The first way that you can prevent yourself from getting sucked into comparison is to avoid your triggers. Seriously, the quickest way to stop comparing your life to somebody else's is just to not start in the first place, right? The first part of this is figuring out what sets you off. Maybe seeing your friend drive a new car makes you really happy for them, but then seeing their beach vacation pictures gets you depressed. That is clearly a trigger for you. This will take a little self-awareness, but try to notice what you're feeling when you have access to other people's lives. Personally, I have zero interest in designer clothes. I can walk past Coach and Burberry without a second glance. However, if I roll through an expensive neighborhood, I start down the comparison road. And if I think logically about it, I can't handle the house we have, let alone a bigger one with more stuff in it. And yet I struggle with that internal negative response. That is a trigger. You might be like me and not even understand why you have the trigger, but it doesn't really matter why the thing sets you off right now. It just matters that you know that that issue is there. So if you follow someone on social media or there's a coworker that's constantly bragging about things that get you down, do what you can to limit your time around them. I am a big believer in Mel Robbins' Unfollow Friday. If you've got someone that makes you crazy every time you see their stuff, then unfollow, even if it's me. Your mental health is more important to me than any amount of follower numbers. And while you can't necessarily just stop talking to coworkers or driving through expensive neighborhoods, do what you can to limit them. Or at the very least, don't seek them out on purpose. The next way to avoid comparison is to remember that social media is just a highlight reel of other people's lives. You can certainly unfollow people, and if you really struggle, just delete it altogether. However, just know that if you keep it, that sometimes you might come across something that sets you off. But remember, people rarely post any bad things that happen to them on social media. Try to remember all of the stuff that happened in between that friend getting a promotion or their trip to Ireland. Everyone struggles with something, and it's often in silence and behind closed doors. So just remember, what you're seeing is a highlight reel of other people's lives, and that is not a fair yardstick to compare your everyday life with. The next thing to remember is that money doesn't buy happiness. One of the big things that we tend to compare ourselves with is material possessions. But if money made you happy, then you would never hear about a celebrity committing suicide. And yet, it happens a lot. People who seem to have it all from the outside but are completely unhappy on the inside. While some money is necessary to live and have a quality of life so that you can not worry about food or paying the rent or the car payment, but beyond the basics, a boost in your bank account is not going to equal happiness. What will happen, though, is that you are buying misery by comparing your life to some celebrity that has a whole bunch of money that might not actually be that happy. There are other things that you can do for real sustainable happiness. And for more information on that, I'm going to put the article that I wrote about happiness in the description below. However, one of the things that always comes up with happiness and can help with a comparison trap is gratitude. When you find yourself sucked down in the comparison trap, stop and think of three things that you are genuinely grateful for. There are studies that show that gratitude actually changes your brain chemistry and helps improve your mood. And you get bonus happiness points if you happen to be grateful for someone else and you tell them or you write them a thank you note. Both you and the person that you're thankful for will get a boost. The next method that you can use to fight comparison is to actually use your comparison as motivation. Some people are inherently motivated by comparison. They see something that someone else has that they want and it just lights a fire in them to go get it. However, if you're watching this, you are probably more like me, and when you see something that you want that someone else has and you start comparing, you feel defeated. The way you can switch this around is to stop looking at material possessions or vacations or stuff like that. Switch it to a positive personality trait, and then that can be very motivating. When you look at somebody else that has a positive personality trait and you start comparing yourself to them, it's not defeating in the way that it is that if they have a new phone that you don't have. When you compare yourself to somebody else because of looks or something that they have, switch it around to what is amazing about that person that you would like to model. Would you wish to be as generous or skillful or hardworking as that person? And if you can't find anything positive about that person to model your life like, do you really want the rest of your life to look like theirs? And the last thing to help you with the comparison trap is to remember you're only competing with yourself. And no matter who you are, there will always be someone out there that is somehow more than you. Wealthier, smarter, has more likes, retweets, whatever. But as we've talked about, comparing your life with those things can be defeating. You are not that person. The things that you have gone through your life make you unique. And comparing that to someone else is unfair to both of you. Instead of looking outward to measure your progress, look back on your life. Look back and see where you have improved and then work on being a better person than you were yesterday. Seriously, keep your eyes on your own paper and you will be so much happier with what you have than you will if you go outside looking to compare. And that wraps up 5 ways to prevent you from getting sucked down in the comparison trap. I'd love to hear down in the comments which one you think is going to be the most helpful for you. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead down and hit the like button. And if you want more awesome content like this, hit the subscribe button too. If you're interested in more information on this topic, check out the show notes below for some links. I'll also have a link for you to sign up for my newsletter so you can get more awesome content like this delivered straight to your inbox. And if you'd like to work with me, I'll have a link to the page where you can see my programs and schedule your free call with me. Thanks everybody, and I'll see you in the next one.